So I just got back from Coast Airbrush in Anaheim, and I'd been needing a touch-up gun. I kind of wanted a new airbrush, and this seemed like the kind of best of both worlds. Can you not shoot up my stuff? Hey, sweeties. So this thing is the TG5, so it's the 5mm nozzle. The tritium is the trigger gun, the TG, whatever, but it's the micro spray, and I think the only reason it's really different is it comes with this guy right here with that adapter on the bottom. So the other one, if I got the side feed, it actually would let you even do siphon, which was kind of cool, but I think it was like you'd have to deal with spatter and stuff when it got down towards the end. I do like kind of smaller amounts of paint sometimes, so this one you can actually do the cupless mode here. Hang on, if I can get that out, there you go. You can just put it right in there and do a cupless mode, and or if you want to do cars or something, you could do the big stuff. And then what else do we get? That stuff's pretty sweet for a chick's car. Hang on, this is like some sweet paint. The house of color set up there. There you go. Don Juan Rose. And we got some pink candy. And this stuff's cool. Let's get some flake. But it's like not just normal pink flake. It's like a rainbow pink flake. I don't know. A chromatic flake, right? Actually, it was pretty good price on that stuff. Some auto reducer and just normal water-based reducer. So, whoa. Did I explode that thing or what? Almost. And then, yeah, a little shimmering. This is like the ice pearls, so it's like white, and then if you get it just right on, because I got the bike with the green. If I can get it right, I don't know. You might see it, might not. There it goes. So you should see some green in there, anyhow. But it's pretty much clear all the rest of the time, so. Yeah, I mean, it comes with the fan spray. It's kind of cool, because it comes with the quick release right here. Like, you got the MAC valve. It's got the quick release. So you can just pop it on, and then control valve. Trigger feels really nice. I've been rocking Iwatas and Badger. I don't think I have a Badger. Pache the Talon. Got the TG3 or whatever. And honestly, that thing clogs up and it destroys the tips real easy. The fluid tips. The needles are pretty heavy duty, but so this guy right here, I kind of like it. I mean, everybody's heard about the magnetic tip on it. Man, what's on my thumb? Whatever. So these things are magnetic tip right there. The crown protects the needle. And then it came with, you can actually stick it on the back, but it came with the little crown once you get closer. And then if you want to rock the bigger nozzle, which is what it had on it when I first opened it. There you go. If I can get some focusing here. And again, sorry about that nail, but whatever. Gee, I play with paint. What do you expect? So that's the fan tip. There it goes. Maybe it'll focus. Yeah, there you go. And, yeah. So that just, you unscrew this whole, it's not just the very tip right there, it's this guy right here. Little critters. You know, rats, you, right? They're actually pretty awesome animals. So there's your tip. Yep. I should stick that little hole.
No,
and then this guy goes. It's alright. And then this guy goes right on over it. Hopefully I just don't want to damage the needle. So I can pull my head out of my ass for long enough to do this. There we go. Yeah, I got the reducer because I didn't want to. I've got some, not candy concentrates from House of Colors, but I got that Createx. It's the aniline dye. So I got that, and it's like, you can, it'll mix with straight acetone by itself, but if you mix it with any water-based, just like mediums and stuff, it doesn't want to mix. It just like clumps, kind of like strings up. It's really messed up actually, and so it just makes a mess, and I don't want to deal with it. So I got some reducers. I wasn't sure if I needed the automotive or the just normal stuff, but the normal stuff said it worked with any Createx stuff. It should work with that, but since the H2 whatever, the candy dyes, the aniline dyes and stuff are actually, I think they're the whatever the hell it's called, the auto eric stuff or whatever. I hope, I think, I'm not sure, whatever. Worst case, I just mix up some House of Colors inner coat clear or some of that custom show clear. I just didn't want to do that because besides the fact it's a bitch to clean out of the gun, it's just, yeah, I mean, you got to let it set, and it's, I mean, it's really expensive too, so I prefer not to have to just mix it up just to test spray some candies. So yeah, we'll see how it sprays in a minute and give you an opinion, but it comes kind of nice little carrying case and stuff. Like, it's not, you know. Oh, what'd you do?
I made her a harness.
Oh my god. And that's a, what are you using, my TIG welding wire? And what? What else is wrapped around her?
Little rubber bands.
Oh, okay. I'm like,
I tie them together and then put
that's so freaking funny.
One around each arm.
Yeah, there you go. Let's check this out. So it comes with this little case thing. Slides open, locks. I mean, it's kind of cool. And then I've got that big, I've got the California Air Tools 20 gallon, 2 horsepower aluminum, supposed to be quiet, but it's really not, air compressor. So I mean, I guess it's quiet when it's running. It's running right now, but whenever it fires off, it does a auto drain valve thing, so, and then it releases pressure out of the cylinder so that it's easy, because it's, you know, it's oilless, so it does this really loud like purging noise, and it, even when I'm like painting models and stuff, it makes them jump. It's pretty horrible, but once it's running, you can't hear it, so it's not bad. But yeah, hopefully I can fix up her helmet because I kind of botched it. That's what happens when you don't mix the candy right. I mean, I can't say it doesn't look like okay, but I mean, we weren't trying to go with Wizard of Oz here. We were going more with, you know, that like lime green. I just did blue, like a really light blue. It was like an electric blue candy from Spastix over, that's what that is right there, over like a yellow, like a transparent yellow. And there's some green flake in there. And I mean, it's kind of cool, but then I did this. I just sprayed on there. I totally horribly did it. I used a 2K clear over the top of it. I fucked it up, dude. So I'm going to touch up my helmet too. I don't know where I put it, but I've got like this chrome on my helmet. So I'm going to try to put some candy on the chrome and see if I can re-clear it. We'll see. But yeah, I'll let you know what I think. This should have a pretty cool spray pattern. Hope you enjoy. I don't know. What do you guys rock? I had an option of buying a custom Micron CMC Plus today for $400, like damn near brand new. Kind of wish I would have done it because this was three, but honestly, I mean, I'm 40 years old, dude. My hands are getting kind of like tired of holding a press a little button. This just seems like it's better. I mean, that's all air, and then that's paint. It's got that little valve back here so you can set it, you know, fixed, whatever. And who doesn't need a touch-up gun? $300, expensive, but who doesn't need it? It feels really good in the hand, though. All right. Hey, little turds. What you doing? You rats are funny as shit. Bye.